Hello everyone, I am Tanvi Kaur and I welcome you to this series called Finance Current Affairs. In this very series, we'll be picking up some important financial topics and we'll be discussing them with the help of different questions. So before moving on to question number one, if you are there for the very first time, you can subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon so that whenever a new video comes up, you can be notified about the same. You can also join our Telegram group where we'll keep you posted about all our upcoming videos and all sorts of free material which is to be provided. You will get the access to Telegram only. Now moving on to question number one, which says RBI has come up with a set of master directions that shall come into force on Jan 3rd, 2022, named as RBI Market Makers in OTC Derivative Directions 2021. Which of the following entities are covered in this set of master directions to which these directions are applicable? So recently, RBI has come up with this set of master directions called RBI Market Makers in OTC Derivatives Directions. So these will be applicable from the year 2022 onwards. So the question is asking about the applicability of these directions. Ye directions kin entities pe applicable hai. So in today's session, we'll be discussing this set of master directions in detail. All the questions today are related to this set of master directions only. So please pay kind attention to its explanation. One thing I would like to tell you beforehand only, in this set of master directions, they have talked about different types of derivatives like credit default swaps, currency swaps, foreign exchange swaps, then different kinds of options. So they have just defined these derivatives in the master directions. In master directions, mein ye kuch derivatives hain jo abhi hum discuss karenge, inko define kiya gaya hai. But kahin pe bhi inke detailed examples ke through inhe define nahi kiya gaya, sirf definition hai. इस सेशन में मैं आपको ये डेफिनेशन के अलावा एग्जांपल्स के थ्रू ये डेरिवेटिव समझाऊंगी. सो दैट विल बी जस्ट फॉर योर क्लैरिटी. आपको वो डेरिवेटिव समझ आए इसलिए आई हैव एडेड दी एग्जांपल्स. दिस इज नॉट जस्ट अ कॉन्सेप्ट टू बी अंडरस्टूड एज अ पार्ट ऑफ मास्टर डायरेक्शंस बट ऑल्सो इट्स पार्ट ऑफ योर स्टैटिक पोर्शन. डिफरेंट क्वेश्चंस कैन बी फ्रेम्ड रिलेटेड टू डेरिवेटिव्स बोथ इन योर डिस्क्रिप्टिव पार्ट इन योर ऑब्जेक्टिव पार्ट. दीज क्वेश्चंस कैन ऑल्सो बी आस्क्ड ड्यूरिंग द इंटरव्यूज. So, in order to make sure that you better understand these types of derivatives, I have added the examples as well. So, ye example master direction ka part nahi hai, ye sirf aapki clarity ke liye add kiye gaye hai. So, let's first discuss the directions and then we'll answer the questions. So, first of all, talking about its commencement and applicability. So, as the question also mentions that these directions will come into force from January 3rd, 2022. So, agle saal January se ye directions in force mein hongi. And talking about its applicability, kin entities ko ye directions applicable hai? They are applicable to entities that are permitted to act as market maker in OTC derivatives. So, jo entities OTC derivatives mein as a market maker work karne ke liye permitted hai, un entities ke liye ye directions hai. So, what is OTC derivatives? First of all, you must understand what are derivatives. So, recently I took one session where I explained about the derivatives. That derivatives are the financial instruments whose value is derived from some other assets. Different commodities, currencies can be there based on which the value of this contract is derived. So derivative is a financial instrument whose value depends on some other underlying asset. Forwards, futures, options, swaps, these are all different types of derivatives. So derivatives can either be traded on an exchange, or if they are not traded on an exchange, they can be traded in over-the-counter market. So OTC stands for over-the-counter market, where instead of being traded on an exchange, the derivatives are traded through the broker-dealer network. Okay, jo alag-alag brokers, dealers hai, unke through exchanges hote hai. Specific stock exchange mein trading nahin hoti hai. That's a OTC derivative. OTC derivative is a derivative other than those traded on exchanges and include those traded on इलेक्ट्रॉनिक ट्रेडिंग प्लेटफॉर्म. सो अलग अलग इलेक्ट्रॉनिक ट्रेडिंग प्लेटफॉर्म्स बने हैं जहाँ पे डीलर नेटवर्क के थ्रू ट्रेडिंग होती है. दैट्स अ ओटीसी डेरिवेटिव. talking about market maker. So market maker means an entity which provides the prices to the users and other market makers. So those entities which basically facilitate the buying and selling of these instruments, which help to determine the price of these instruments for the users, those entities are known as the market makers. So as per the Foreign Exchange Management Act, those which are authorized, the authorized persons means ones authorized under the Act to undertake the foreign exchange derivative transactions are the market makers for such transactions. Alright, so commencement or applicability, I hope aapko samajh aa gayi hogi. Ab hum jaate hain aage definitions ki taraf. So this is important part of master directions and this is important for your understanding about your derivatives as well. So first instrument which they have defined is a credit default swap. I think I took one session, maybe it might be in the month of February or March, where I discussed about this credit default swap. Us time pe koi news mein tha ye credit default swap. RBI ne iske against kuch directions issue kiye the. So I discussed this there in detail. Let me discuss it briefly over here as well. So credit default swap is basically a derivative. Here, because they are talking about over-the-counter market, so we'll say it's a over-the-counter derivative in which one counterparty commits to pay the other in the case of a credit event with respect to a reference entity, and in return the protection buyer is the other counterparty, and the protection buyer makes periodic premium to the protection seller. So there are two entities. One entity is the protection seller, other is the protection buyer. So the protection seller commits to pay some amount to the counterparty, that is protection buyer, provided that that protection buyer provides certain premium to the protection seller to get protection against some credit default risk. So I'll explain you this with an example. Now there might be a person, a company, which is in need of some funds. किसी कंपनी को पैसा चाहिए किसी पर्पस के लिए. सो व्हाट इट कैन डू, इट कैन टेक सम लोन्स, इट कैन इशू सम बॉन्ड्स एंड रेज द मनी यूजिंग दोज बॉन्ड्स. सो सपोज दिस पर्सन इज इन नीड ऑफ अ मनी, ओके, सो इट इशूज द बॉन्ड्स. वी कैन से दिस इज अ कंपनी व्हिच इज इशूइंग, दिस द पर्सन हु इज इशूइंग सम बॉन्ड्स ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द कंपनी, ओके. सो ही इज इन नीड ऑफ मनी, सो ही इशूज बॉन्ड्स. Now when he is issuing bonds, there will be some person, some entity which will be subscribing to these bonds, buying these bonds. So that person becomes the bond holder. Now what this, so this bond holder is basically an investor. He is investing the money. By way of his investment, this person is getting the money. Ab kya ho raha hai, ye person ko paise ki zarurat thi, isne bonds issue kiye, is person ne bonds khareed liye. Ek investor tha, inke paas paisa tha invest karne ke liye, inhone wo bonds khareed liye. Now for whatever time period those bonds have been taken, this person needs to return back the principal amount with some interest back to the person who has invested in those bonds. जिसने bonds खरीदे हैं उसको आपको थोड़े time बाद जाके पैसा उसका with interest वापस करना होगा. Now the one who is investing the money in the bonds, that is who is providing the money in the form of bonds to this bond issuer, he runs the risk that that person might default and would not be able to pay back the money. So इन्होंने bond खरीद के इस company को, इस person को पैसा तो दे दिया, लेकिन default risk, credit risk है कि ये person default कर जाएगा और future में payment नहीं कर पाएगा. So in order to get the protection against this credit risk, this default risk, this person bond holder, which over there, over so which in this very case is the protection buyer, will thus take a protection where there will be some credit protection seller, koi company, koi entity, koi person hoga jo ye protection de raha hai ki agar aap unko timely premiums pay karte rahoge to wo aapko ek protection denge ki agar ye person default kar gaya to aapko wo wali payment ye protection company de degi. So here in return of some payments which you are making, some premiums which you are paying to this protection seller, protection seller provides you the protection against the default by this bond issuer. So such a contract where in case this person will not be able to pay you and the person defaults, then this company will pay you on behalf of that person. Such a contract is a credit default swap. I hope aapko ye concept clear ho gaya hoga. Moving ahead to the next instrument now, which is currency swap. So currency swap is again a derivative being talked about, which commits two counterparties to exchange stream of interest payments, and they might also exchange the principal amounts in different currencies on a specified date over the duration of the swap at a pre-agreed exchange rate. So what is happening over here? At a pre-agreed specified date, you are exchanging the interest payments with the other party. So yahan interest payments ka exchange ho raha hai. Principal amount bhi aap exchange kar sakte ho. Let us understand this with an example. Suppose there is an American company who might be able to borrow from America at 6%. So ek US ki company hai jo US se 6% rate pe loan le sakti hai. Then but it is in need of rand for an investment in South Africa. इस यूएस की कंपनी ने साउथ अफ्रीका में कोई इन्वेस्टमेंट करनी है जिसके लिए उनको वहां की करेंसी की जरूरत है एंड द रेट ऑफ बोरिंग ओवर देयर इज 9%. सो इफ दिस यूएस फर्म बोरोज फ्रॉम साउथ अफ्रीका देन इट हैज टू पे 9% इंटरेस्ट 9% इट हैज टू पे द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ 9% टू बोरो दैट मनी फ्रॉम साउथ अफ्रीका. At the same time, there is also a South African company that wishes to finance a project in US. So, जैसे कि ये US की company थी जिसने South Africa में investment करनी है, जिस वजह से उन्हें वहाँ की currency चाहिए, ऐसे ही यहाँ पे एक South African company है जिन्हें US dollars की ज़रूरत है क्योंकि वो वहाँ पे कोई project finance करना चाहते हैं. But if it is going to borrow from US, then it will get the money at 11% rate. And if they borrow from their own country in their own currency, then 8% is the rate. So, वैसे US में जो rate है, वो 6% है borrow करने का. लेकिन अगर South Africa की firm वहाँ आके borrow करती है, तो उन्हें 11% rate pay करना पड़ेगा. वही South Africa में rate है 8%. लेकिन अगर US की company South Africa में आके borrow करती है, तो उन्हें 9% rate देना पड़ेगा. So, you can see they have to pay more if they borrow funds from other country in their currency. So what is the solution to this? The solution to this is a currency swap. Each party can benefit from other's interest rate through the currency swap. So what will happen in case of a currency swap? They will agree to exchange the interest payments in different currencies. So the American company will borrow from US the dollars at 6%. And because South African company was in need of dollars, then this American company will provide those dollars to the South African company at 6%. And the South African company needs dollars and it can easily raise the funding in rands at a lower rate in South Africa. So it will borrow from South Africa at 8% and lend the funds to the US company at 8%. So, यहाँ क्या हो रहा है, क्योंकि US अपनी कंट्री में 6% पे बोरो, US की कोई कंपनी अपनी कंट्री में 6% पे डॉलर्स बोरो कर सकती है, तो वो 6% पे बोरो कर लेगी एंड वो साउथ अफ्रीकन कंपनी को 6% पे ही लेंड कर देगी. एंड साउथ अफ्रीकन कंपनी जो है वो अपनी कंट्री में अपनी करेंसी पे लोअर इंटरेस्ट रेट पे बोरोइंग कर सकती है. सो वो 8% अपनी करेंसी को ही रेट पे अपनी करेंसी का कुछ अमाउंट बोरो करेगी और वो यूएस की फर्म को 8% पे प्रोवाइड कर देगी. इससे क्या है, दोनों कंपनीज को बेनिफिट हो जाएगा, दोनों को ज़्यादा इंटरेस्ट रेट नहीं पे करना पड़ेगा और दोनों को ही उस करेंसी में बोरोइंग मिल जाएगी जिसमें वो उस प्रोजेक्ट के लिए चाहते थे. This is the whole concept of currency swap. Not only they will exchange the interest payments, they might also exchange the principal payments at whatever spot rate is prevailing. Okay, so this is the concept of currency swap. I hope it's clear now. Moving ahead to the next derivative, which is foreign exchange forward. So abhi tak hum swaps ki baat kar rahe the, ab aaya hai forward contract. So foreign exchange forward is also a derivative which involves exchange of two currencies on a specified date in future at an agreed rate on a date of contract. So what is happening over here? Here you are exchanging two currencies. यहाँ पे दो currencies exchange हो रही है. पिछले case में एक swap था, वहाँ पे आप क्या कर रहे थे, interest rates जो different currencies में है उन्हें swap कर रहे थे. यहाँ क्या हो रहा है, here you are owing certain currency and you are exchanging that at an agreed rate. So let's understand this with an example. Suppose the company has to settle the account with suppliers in US dollar terms by paying them 1 lakh US dollars after 3 months. So एक company है, उन्होंने कुछ suppliers से कुछ प्रोडक्ट या कुछ मटेरियल मंगाया एंड दैट कंपनी आफ्टर 3 months हैज टू पे $1 lakh ओके 1 lakh US dollars 3 महीने बाद इस कंपनी ने सप्लायर को पे करने हैं. नाउ द कंपनी इज अर्निंग इन यूरोस. कंपनी जो है वो यूरो में अर्न करती है लेकिन उन्हें पेमेंट जो करनी है वो डॉलर में करनी है. द कंपनी कैन दस कंक्लूड अ फॉरवर्ड US डॉलर परचेज ट्रांजैक्शन वेयर इट विल अग्री विद द बैंक दैट इट विल बाय US डॉलर्स अगेंस्ट यूरो एट अ फिक्स्ड रेट फॉर 1.30 US डॉलर्स फॉर यूरोस. And on expiry, the US dollar exchange rate stands at 1.28, but the company buys it at 1.30 only. अब इस कंपनी को इस सप्लायर को डॉलर में पेमेंट करनी है बट इट इज अर्निंग इन यूरोज. नाउ वॉट कैन हैपन बिकॉज इट हैज टू मेक अ पेमेंट इन डॉलर्स आफ्टर 3 months. सो वट एवर एक्सचेंज रेट इज प्रिवेलिंग टूडे इट माइट चेंज इन फ्यूचर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ फॉर 1 euro टूडे यू आर गेटिंग 1.30 US dollars. इन फ्यूचर दिस रेट माइट चेंज एंड फॉर 1 euro यू माइट गेट जस्ट 1.20 US dollars. So then the situation will change or the rate might exceed from 1.30. 1 euro might become 1.40 US dollars. So इस केस में जब चेंज हो जाएगा तो आपको चेंज रेट ना पे करना पड़े. यू कैन ऑलरेडी फिक्स अ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट बिफोर हैंड. दिस इज अ फॉरवर्ड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. सो हेयर वॉट इज हैपनिंग हेयर द कंपनी इज doing a contract with a bank where it will buy the US dollars at this fixed rate. So ye company 3 mahine baad bank se 1 euro deke 1.30 US dollar le legi. So this is the rate which they have agreed ki agar aap bank ko 1 euro doge to bank aapko uske badle 1.30 US dollars dega and you can use those US dollars to pay that supplier. Now, what is happening? Suppose at the time of expiration, that is after 3 months, this rate changes. Pehle rate tha 1 euro 1.30 dollar ke barabar, ab wo ho gaya 1 euro 1.28 dollar ke barabar. Ab usi 1 euro mein aapko kam US dollars milenge. But because you have already entered into a contract to get 1.30, you will be saved from such a situation. So, agar euro ki value depreciate ho jati hai, ओके यूरो के बदले अब आपको कम डॉलर्स मिल रहे हैं उस केस में आप प्रोटेक्टेड हो जाओगे अगर आपने फॉरवर्ड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट ऑलरेडी अग्री किया हुआ था. सो आपने पहले ही अग्री कर लिया था कि आपको 1 euro के बदले इतना ही डॉलर मिलेगा तो अगर वैल्यू कम भी हो जाती है आपको उतना ही डॉलर मिलेगा और आप उस डॉलर को यूज करके उस सप्लायर को पे कर सकते हो. नाउ मूविंग अहेड टू द फॉरेन एक्सचेंज ऑप्शंस. सो वी डिस्कस्ड फॉरेन एक्सचेंज फॉरवर्ड. Foreign exchange options differ a bit. So in a forward, there is a obligation that you have to adhere to the contract. But in foreign exchange option, you don't have an obligation. You just have a right which you can exercise. Okay. So foreign exchange call option is a derivative which gives the buyer the right, not the obligation to buy at an agreed amount of a certain currency with another currency at a specified exchange. And if I talk about a put option, then put is the option to sell, call is the option to buy. So in case of a foreign exchange call option, you have an option, you have a right which you can exercise where you will buy a certain currency for other currency at a rate which you have pre-decided on some future date which you have already specified. Put option is the option that you will sell your currency for some another currency at a rate agreed beforehand on an agreed date on future. तो ये बेसिक डिफरेंस है फॉरवर्ड्स और ऑप्शंस में. मूविंग अहेड टू द फॉरेन एक्सचेंज स्वैप नाउ. सो व्हाट इज अ फॉरेन एक्सचेंज स्वैप. इट्स अ डेरिवेटिव व्हिच इन्वॉल्व्स एक्चुअल एक्सचेंज ऑफ टू करेंसीज प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट ओनली ऑन स्पेसिफाइड डेट इन अ शॉर्ट लेग एंड रिवर्स एक्सचेंज ऑफ सेम करेंसीज इन फ्यूचर ऑन लॉन्ग लेग एट अ रेट अग्रीड एट द टाइम ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. सो व्हाट इज हैपनिंग हियर. देयर आर हियर वी एक्सचेंज टू करेंसीज. So suppose there is one party and there is other party. It is they are exchanging the currencies. Okay, the principal amount they are exchanging today at some rate and then they will return back that money in their respective currencies in a future date at a rate which has already been agreed. So let's understand this with an example. यहाँ पे basically principal जो currency है वो आज आप exchange कर रहे हो किसी रेट पे और फ्यूचर के लिए आप रेट डिसाइड कर रहे हो जब उस करेंसी को आप वापस एक्सचेंज बैक करोगे. सपोज देयर आर टू पार्टीज पार्टी ए and party B. Okay, so party A is a Canadian company. It's from Canada. And it needs euro. What it needs? It needs euros. Party B is an European company. So means it has euros. And it needs Canadian dollars. So what they can do? ये Canada की company है जिसके पास Canadian dollars है लेकिन euro की ज़रूरत है. ये European company है जिनके पास euro है लेकिन Canadian dollars की ज़रूरत है. So both of them can enter into a foreign exchange swap where they will exchange this currency which they have at some agreed rate. So initially, in short term, say today, they will exchange the money at prevailing rate, and then in future also they will exchange back the money at a rate pre-decided. So suppose आज रेट है कि एक यूरो जो है वो 1.5 कैनेडियन डॉलर्स के बराबर है. So if a contract is worth 1 lakh euro, suppose, okay. So company B has euros, it will pay these euros to A, and A has dollars, Canadian dollars, it will pay them to B. So company B will make a payment of 1 lakh euros to A. So A receives 1 lakh euros. And those, if 1 euro is 1.5 Canadian dollars, 1 lakh euro will be 1.5 lakh Canadian dollars. So this company, company A, will pay company B 1,50,000 Canadian dollars. So today they have made this exchange at a rate of 1 euro is equal to 1.5 Canadian dollars, where company B is paying 1 lakh euro to A and A is paying 1,50,000 Canadian dollars to B. Now they also agree for a future rate. Now they are expecting, now they, what was expectation, that in future the Canadian dollar might depreciate relative to euro. So they have pre-decided the rate, and the rate is 1 euro at for 1.6 Canadian dollars. Future mein expectation hai ki euro ki value badegi, Canadian dollar ki kam hogi, depreciate hogi. So they agree to certain rate because they expect in future the rates might change. Now if the rate changes in future, they will execute the contract at an agreed rate only. So suppose they have agreed that 1 euro is equal to 1.6 Canadian dollar would be the rate at which they will exchange back the principal amount in future. So in future, say after 6 months, this company will pay back in pay back the amount, and this company will pay back the amount to company A. So A returns, A has taken the euros, so after 6 months, A will return 1 lakh euros. ओके यूरो की वैल्यू इतनी है, कैनेडियन डॉलर हो गए अब एक यूरो के बराबर 1.6 रेट के हिसाब से. सो द कंपनी ए रिटर्न्स 1 लाख यूरोस एंड कंपनी बी विल रिटर्न द कैनेडियन डॉलर्स, बट दिस टाइम 1,60,000 कैनेडियन डॉलर्स. दिस विल एंड द फॉरेन एक्सचेंज स्वैप. सो दिस इज हाउ इट फंक्शंस. ऑलराइट, मूविंग अहेड टू नेक्स्ट इंस्ट्रूमेंट नाउ, दैट इज इंटरेस्ट रेट कॉल ऑप्शन. European. See, they have written the word European over here. We can have European options also and American options also. American options are those which you can exercise before maturity. But Europeans are the one which you can exercise only on maturity date. So talking about interest rate call and put options now. So we know call is the option to buy, put is the option to sell. So what are these interest rate options? The interest rate options give the buyer the right, not the obligation, to buy an interest rate instrument or receive an interest payment, interest rate on a principal at a predetermined price on a specified date in future. And same if it is a contract to sell the interest rate instrument, pay the interest rate, then it's an interest rate put option. So understanding this with an example, a call option gives the holder the right, not the obligation, to benefit from the rising interest rate. The investor holding the call option earns a profit if at the expiry of the option the interest rates have risen and trading at a rate higher than the strike price, high enough to cover the premium. So if what happens if in future the interest rates actually rise, then you can exercise the call option, you can buy the interest rate instrument because you will be receiving the interest rates at a higher prevailing rate in that case. And if there is an expectation and your expectation comes to be true and the interest rates start falling, then you can exercise the interest rate put option where you will make the payment because the interest rates are lower. This is how the interest rate options work. Moving next to the interest rate swap now. So it's a contract where two counterparties agree to exchange one stream of future interest payments for another. So यहाँ पे interest payments का exchange हो रहा है. Okay, at a rate, at a principal applied on a notional principal amount over a specified period. So let's understand this also with an example. Suppose there are two companies that make an interest rate swap of $1,00,000. Company A is there, company B is there. It might be earning some fixed rate. Say it is earning 5% rate. Company B might be on a floating rate where say it might be earning a rate, right? LIBOR or something like that plus 1%. Okay. Now company A believes that the interest rates are likely to rise in future, and if it stays at fixed rate, it will not be able to benefit. But if it can shift to a floating rate, it can benefit. इन्हें लगता है कि future में rate बढ़ेगा, say 5% से बढ़के 6% हो जाएगा. But because company A ने agree किया हुआ है कि वो 5% fixed interest ही earn करेगी, तो वो इस increased interest rate का फायदा नहीं उठा पाएंगे. Now there is company B which feels the opposite, which is more pessimistic. It believes that it is earning floating rate today, but in future, this interest rate might reduce. So, abhi suppose LIBOR 5 tha. Suppose LIBOR 4% tha. Toh 4 plus 1, 5% abhi ye floating earn kar rahi hai. Inhe lagta hai future mein LIBOR jaake 3% ho jayega. Agar 3% hua, toh 3 plus 1, 4% interest rate ye earn karenge. So, interest rates inke kam hone ki wajah se, inka return jo hai, wo kam ho jayega. So, what they can do? They can enter into an interest rate swap. So company A is motivated that the prices might increase in future, B is motivated that it can reduce in future. So what will happen? Company B is motivated by a desire to secure risk protection against declining rate in the form of getting fixed returns. So they enter into a swap agreement. So ye aapas mein agree kar lete hain that this will company will be paying a floating rate to this and this will be paying a fixed rate to B. This is an interest rate swap. Alright, I hope the concept is clear. Now this was all about the definitions. यहाँ different types के हमने derivatives discuss किए. तो ये explanations नहीं थी इतनी ज़्यादा directions में, आपकी clarity के लिए मैंने explain किया है. इस master directions में basic focus रहा है governance पे, कैसे over the counter market में जो derivatives की trading होती है उनकी governance improve कर सकते हैं. This set of master directions has mainly focused on governance of the over the counter market. So let's see what norms, rules, regulations this very set of directions has proposed. So first very governance direction is that the board of directors and senior management of market maker should adhere to certain things. So jo board of directors hain aur jo senior management hai market maker entity ki, unhe kya kya cheeze follow karni hai. First is they have to have good understanding about the nature of derivatives which they are undertaking. So, jis bhi derivatives mein wo deal kar rahe hai, uski thorough knowledge unhe honi chahiye. They need strong commitment for effective risk management and compliance environment. So, unhe proper risk management pe focus karna hai, comply karna hai, sare rules regulations ke saath. They also need to ensure implementation of certain things. Ab ye kuch cheeze hai jo unhe implement karni hai. What are these? First is adequate and effective risk management, internal control, policy and procedures which commensurate with the complexity of products. So, जो भी complex products हैं, उससे match करने के लिए आप accordingly internal control policies बनाओ, risk management policies बनाओ, procedures बनाओ और उन्हें execute करो. Then, appropriate organization structure should be there with clarity on responsibility and accountability, staff and other resources. For prudent conduct of derivative business. So, derivative business आपको करना है, proper किसकी क्या authority है, कौन किसको accountable है, कौन किसको responsible है, proper organization structure होना चाहिए. Okay, risk management function, internal control, internal audit, everything should be there in place. Then, effective measures should be taken towards regulatory compliance and effective measures to address internal and external audits. So, properly internal external audit karo, sare rules regulations ke saath comply karo, ye sare responsibilities hai board of directors or senior management ki of the market maker. Then, talking about general responsibility which can help ensure corporate governance. So, baki kya general responsibilities hai? Board of directors need to approve written policies which define overall framework for derivative business. So, जो भी derivatives में आप deal करना चाहते हो, उसके लिए एक approved written policy होनी चाहिए, जिसे board of director approve करेंगे, उस पॉलिसी में उस पूरे उस पॉलिसी में पूरा डेरिवेटिव बिजनेस का फ्रेमवर्क होना चाहिए. सो फ्रेमवर्क में क्या क्या इंक्लूडेड है वो देख लेते हैं. द पॉलिसी शुड हैव द एंटायर फ्रेमवर्क फॉर योर डेरिवेटिव बिजनेस. व्हाट शुड बी देयर इन दैट फ्रेमवर्क? इट शुड कवर द फॉलोइंग. फर्स्ट, द एंटिटीज ओवरऑल एपिटाइट फॉर रिस्क. Ensure it's consistent with its objective, strategic objective, capital strength and capability to manage risk. So, आपकी कितनी appetite है risk bear करने की, ये mentioned होना चाहिए. Okay, it will be dependent on what is your capacity to deal with the risks, what are your strategic objectives, आपकी capital strength कितनी है, ऐसे कई factors पे आपकी risk appetite depend करेगी. तो आपको एक अपनी risk appetite determine करनी है. You need to specify the permitted activities, products and limits for derivative business. So, क्या activities हैं जो आप allowed हो करने के लिए, क्या products हैं जिनमें आप deal कर सकते हो, क्या limit है कि किस से ज़्यादा amount की dealing नहीं करनी, सब कुछ आपको derivative business से associated specify करना है इस policy में. Then you also need to establish policies for these things. So, ये जो अभी मैं discuss करूँगी, इसको further इस session में detail में discuss किया गया है. इससे रिलेटेड पॉलिसीज बनानी है. किससे रिलेटेड पॉलिसीज बनानी है? पॉलिसीज रिलेटेड टू इंट्रोड्यूसिंग न्यू ओवर द काउंटर डेरिवेटिव प्रोडक्ट, रिलेटेड टू प्री ट्रेड ड्यू डिलिजेंस, रिलेटेड टू रिस्क मैनेजमेंट, इंटरनल कंट्रोल, इंटरनल ऑडिट. दीज प्रिंसिपल्स शुड बी फॉलोड एंड पॉलिसीज रिलेटेड टू दीज शुड बी देयर एंड एडेड टू द फ्रेमवर्क टू बी अप्रूव बाय बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स. ओके, सो इन सब चीज़ों में फर्दर क्या क्या आता है वो डिस्कस कर लेते हैं. फर्स्ट is related to introducing new OTC derivative products. So, जब new OTC derivative products हमने introduce करने हैं, तो क्या चीज़ें हैं जो ध्यान में रखनी है, जिन्हें adhere करना है, क्या guidelines हैं? Let's see those guidelines that relate to introducing new over-the-counter product. So, the policy to introduce such products should have a evaluation and approval process. So, कोई भी नए product को आपने approval देना है या उसको evaluate करना है, तो क्या process follow करोगे, वो आपकी पॉलिसी का पार्ट होना चाहिए. ओके, प्रॉपर एक पॉलिसी होनी बनानी है और उनका पार्ट ये होना, प्रोसेस होना चाहिए. देन परमिटेड प्रोडक्ट्स. सो मार्केट मेकर्स विल डील ओनली इन परमिटेड प्रोडक्ट्स एज पर गवर्निंग डायरेक्शंस. सो एज पर द डायरेक्शंस यू विल डिसाइड विच प्रोडक्ट्स यू आर अलाउड टू डील विद एंड यू विल ओनली डील इन दोज प्रोडक्ट्स. जो प्रोडक्ट्स पे आपने अग्री किया है उसके अलावा आप किसी और प्रोडक्ट में डीलिंग नहीं कर सकते हो. देन इज ड्यू डिलिजेंस. Due diligence for introducing new product should include an assessment of following. So, as far as the due diligence is concerned, when you have to come up with new product, you need to assess the product on certain points, on certain aspects. So, kya aspects hai jiske basis pe aapko product ko assess karna hai? Product ka objective kya hai? What is its target audience, target client? Okay, how the product will fulfill the need of those target audiences? What are the risks which a client can potentially face with this kind of a product? What is the payoff profile of this product? What is the prices? What are the cost, fee? What measures which you will take when some kind of a conflict of interest arises? So, in sub aspects pe product ko hume assess karna hai. And then, whatever policy is being made, that needs to be approved. Whatever policy is being made to come up with new products, those product related policy needs to be approved by Chief Compliance Officer, by Chief Risk Officer and by the Board of Directors. So, सारे जो products हैं वो market में आने से पहले Board of Director approval से होके गुजरेंगे. Then talking about the pricing and valuation. So, for pricing and valuation, you can either go for mark to market or mark to model kind of a valuation, and whichever method you are using, it should be properly documented. So, mark to market or mark to model में क्या फर्क है? Both are the pricing models, okay, pricing mechanisms. In mark to model, the pricing is based on some kind of a financial model. So, आप किसी financial model के basis पे pricing करते हो, it's different from mark to market because in mark to market, market prices are used to calculate the values. So, mark to market में prices जो है वो market value के basis पे determined होते हैं और mark to product to a model में किसी financial model के basis पे. So, when you are using a financial model, you need to specify what's the purpose of that model, what are the assumptions, what are the input variables, algorithms and all those kinds of stuff. Okay, so this was related to introducing new products in the market. What principles you need to follow while framing the policy related to coming up with new product. Now coming to the pre-trade due diligence. Ab aapne trading karni hai un derivatives ki. So wo trading karne se pehle, trading karte waqt aur trading karne ke baad aapko kya kya cheeze dhyan mein rakhni hai, let us understand that. Before trading, pre-trade conduct, you need to do the user classification, where the users shall be classified and offered derivatives in terms of governing directions. So users ko aap alag alag aspects pe classify karoge, who are more riskier ones, less riskier ones, and then accordingly you will offer them the derivative products. And you can offer only those derivatives which you have agreed as per the governing directions. Then a product disclosure statement is needed. So it will contain standard information about the product made available to the user and provide information to decide if the product will meet the needs and facilitate comparison with other products. So sari information jo hai product related wo user ko deni hai. Kya kya information deni hai? What are the features of the product, the terms and conditions, the benefits, the risks, the payoff profile, cost, fees, how the product works. So this statement needs to be disclosed to the user. Then you need to exercise due diligence. Due diligence in respect of following should be exercised before offering a product to the user. User ko koi derivative instrument dene se pehle aapko kya cheeze dhyan mein rakhni hai? Product suitable ho, user appropriateness ho, or risk disclosure statement ho. So the product should be suitable as per the needs, wants, objectives and risk appetite of the user. User jitni risk bear kar sakta hai, uska jo bhi objective hai, accordingly hi aap unhe derivative offer karo. User appropriateness. A product should be offered only to appropriate user. Now, who is an appropriate user? A one who has the knowledge skill of the product he is going to deal in. Okay. Who has the financial ability to bear the risks which might arise with that product. And one who has risk management framework which is consisting to the product offer. Jo bhi derivative aap us customer ko offer kar rahe ho, usko uske bare mein knowledge honi chahiye, us related skill honi chahiye, us related risk manage karne ki ability honi chahiye, itna wo financially strong hona chahiye. So these are some requirements. Then is risk disclosure. You need to disclose to the user the risks associated with that very derivative product. So jo bhi risks associated hai, wo bhi aap share karo us customer se. Okay. Then is trade conduct. Ab jab trading ho rahi hai, tab kya dhyan mein rakhna hai ki that it is conducted in a fair and transparent manner at the prevailing market rates. And then when once the trade is done, then you need to the confirmation. A deal confirmation needs to be provided to the user and confirmation shall be obtained from him as well. So ek confirmation dono parties ko aapas mein leni hogi ki ye trading hui hai, ye dealing hui hai. This is related to pre and post trade due diligence. Moving ahead to risk management now. Risk management ke liye in market makers ko ya kya karna chahiye? So all risks to which market maker is exposed shall be identified. Okay. So first is risk identification and risk tolerance level should be set. So setting the tolerance level, the risk tolerance levels. Then processes shall be established to manage the risks. So, जो भी risk आपने identify की है, उन्हें manage करने के लिए भी mechanisms बनाओ. A clear and comprehensive set of limits shall be established to manage this risk. अब ये risks manage करने के लिए आप limit set करो अपनी कि आपको ऐसे इससे ज़्यादा risk नहीं लेनी है, इससे ज़्यादा dealing नहीं करनी है, नहीं तो risk बढ़ जाएगी. And then you also need to do stress testing. So stress testing is कि आप अलग अलग scenarios देखो कि ये risky scenario है इस situation में, अगर ऐसी situation आती है तो आप actual कैसे work करोगे, तो आप पहले ही test कर लेते हो. जैसे कि हम अपने exam से पहले mock test लेते हैं ना, कि हम एक idea लग जाए कि actual test में हमारी क्या situation रहेगी, वैसे ही आप risky situations में assess करते हो इन derivatives को to get an idea of what will be your actual true position if that risk arises. So risk manage karne ke liye you need to first identify the risk, set your tolerance level, manage the risk, set the limits to manage the risk and do the stress testing. Okay. Then moving to next part, that is internal control. So policies and procedures should be established to apply internal control at various stages in the workflow of processing. There should be clear separation both between front and back office. So proper internal control mechanisms honi chahiye. Jo aapki dealing kar rahe hain, trading kar rahe hain derivatives ki, aur jo back end pe work kar rahe hain, there should be clear separation of the both. And last thing is related to the conduct of internal audit. So timely audit karna bhi zaruri hai. Derivative businesses shall be subjected to internal audit. Internal audit क्यों जरूरी है? So that you can review the adequacy and test the effectiveness of risk management and internal control. आपके जो भी internal control mechanisms हैं, जो भी risk management frameworks हैं, वो कितने अच्छे से work कर रहे हैं, उन सब का आपको assessment करना बहुत जरूरी है. Then you need audit at a minimum The audit at a minimum will investigate unusual occurrences such as breach of limit, unauthorized trade, unreconciled valuation, accounting differences. So ये जो audit है ये investigate करेगा कि कहीं कोई limit तो नहीं breach हुई है, कहीं कोई unauthorized trade तो नहीं हुआ है, कहीं कोई accounting differences तो नहीं आ रहे. It will also evaluate the reliability and timeliness of the information reported to senior management and board of directors. So, जो भी आप information senior management को दे रहे हो, board of directors को दे रहे हो, वो reliable और timely है कि नहीं, ये audit assess करेगा. Audit will undertake an appraisal of effectiveness of the risk management process. So, जो आप risk management process use कर रहे हो, वो कितने effective हैं, audit जो है, वो इनका assessment करता है. Then it will also evaluate whether risk management practices are comprehensive, whether they are effective or not. It will evaluate product disclosure statement and risk disclosure statement provided to users. So users को जो भी आप disclosures कर रहे हो वो सही है कि नहीं, timely हो रहे हैं कि नहीं, वो सब पे check कर रखता है ये audit. And it should be conducted by qualified professionals independent of business line being audited. Independent professionals होने चाहिए जो audit करेंगे. And if you fail, if there is a failure of management to implement the recommendations of internal auditor within a time frame, then same needs to report it to the audit committee of the board of directors. So this was all about this set of directions. I hope it is clear now. Talking about second question, identify the OTC derivative in which one counterparty commits to pay to other in case of credit event with respect to failure, with respect to reference entity, and in return, the protection buyer makes periodic payments in the form of premium to the protection seller until maturity of the contract or credit event. So, ये पूरा concept है हमारे credit default swap का जो अभी हमने discuss किया कि एक protection seller जो है वो protection buyer को protection देता है अगर third party जिससे against वो protection ली जा रही है वो default कर जाती है in case of a credit default. Okay, so it's a credit default swap. Answer is option B. Moving to next question now. Identify the type of swap derivative discussed in the case below. So, हमने सारे cases discuss कर लिए. Let's see which case is this. Here, there is one Canadian party needing euros, another European needing Canadian dollars. So, they swap today 1 lakh euro dollars at an agreed rate. Then in future, again, they swap back at this rate, which has already been agreed before. So, they are talking about a foreign exchange swap. Okay. Moving to last question now. RBI market makers in OTC derivative directions focus on governance, and so board of directors of market maker need to approve written policies defining the framework within which the derivative business will be conducted and the risks are to be managed. Such framework shall cover risk management specifying which of the following steps. So risk management ke liye kaun kaun se steps important hain jo is directions ne focus kiye hain. Abhi humne discuss kiya related to risk identification, setting the tolerance levels, stress testing, managing the risk, and setting the limits for the risk. So all these were discussed. So answer is option E, all of the above. This was all about today's session. With this, I would like to end up this session. Thank you so much.